By the time you're watching this, time is ticking, right? The holidays are coming and, people are buying now. So don't waste any more time. Hit the ground running. Carve out the time to do something actionable and get it in front of your audience.
Hey everybody, and welcome to another episode of In the Den. Today I am joined by BJ Berge. BJ, say hi.
Hey.
If you don't know who BJ is, he is the one and only BJ Berge here at One SEO. BJ, you've been here for about close to 10 years now?
That is correct.
All right, so you kind of truly understand what we do here and what we're all about, and you know this time of year, a lot of companies, business owners, and even individuals are preparing for the holidays. So let's talk a little bit about what businesses should be doing for their marketing as they prepare for the holiday season.
Absolutely. So I think the key thing to understand here is that there's a lot of noise, especially in this post-pandemic world, of I can go online and be overstimulated to the point that nothing happens, no action is taken. So it's how do you connect with people? What value do you bring to them? What special offers do you bring to the table? And how do you clearly communicate that?
Yeah, so for ideas, there's so much out there, like you said, and you can see so many different companies. You see all the deals and things like that that come about on the holidays. It's a bit overwhelming. So where should businesses start first? Where should they turn to come up with some ideas and really help spearhead their holiday marketing?
Absolutely. I'm going to tell you guys to look at what the big name brands are doing out there. You know, look at their ads. What are they running? Visually, what do they look like? You know, it's formulaic at the end of the day, right? So is it a clear, concise message that can be easily construed on Facebook when somebody's scrolling? Is it a power statement in a Google advertisement that is making you stand out from the competition who's right next to you? You know, look at what they're doing, because, you know, the days of reinventing the wheel are over. It's who's doing it the cleanest, and who stands out.
Okay, so let's kind of talk a little bit about the creation of it, right? So everyone kind of sits when it comes to marketing, especially in the holiday time when you're super busy, and they think, I don't have time for this. Maybe they have an agency, maybe they don't have an agency, but they don't want to invest. What are some things that they can do to help them get marketing ideas? You talked about mimicking success, but what about reusing content that's out there as well?
Absolutely. I tell everybody, everything's been done, it hasn't been done by you. If somebody is not playing your jurisdiction, is not a national brand or something, utilize what they have that's successful. Utilize your old stuff that may have worked 2, 3, 4 years ago. Capitalize on that and build something that is your own. You know, take 30, 40% of it and work on top of that. Rather than, just hit the drawing board and try to figure out what you can come up with, emulate something. You know, don't waste your time. Put your cell phone to work and take a brand new picture if you need to for your ad, whatever it may be.
So I think the two big tips that you kind of gave out there is, one, mimic successful campaigns that you already see. Find someone who's doing it and doing it well and see how you can do it. And then also I think another benefit is that people don't have to reinvent the wheel every single year. Take what you did from the previous years and then enhance it, right? That's how you continue to improve and how you get better.
100%.
So listen, two tips, take those, right? Mimic success or reuse content that you already have, just make it better. So let's switch a little bit of gears. We've talked about this on the show before, but how can clients, customers, business owners, how can they use their existing data to help enhance their marketing?
So this is awesome. So, if we're tracking analytics, if we're seeing analytical data in Facebook/Instagram, in any channel that we may have that data, we're going to have, age ranges. We're going to have, sex, male or female. We're going to have, demographic as far as geography, as far as household income, marital status. That type of stuff is invaluable when putting these ad sets together and who you're talking to. Because you may swear up and down that your clientele are one demographic, but the data is going to tell you another story. So you want to cater to them. And sometimes, if the time affords luxury, you should be catering to two subsets of your audience in two different, very different ways. This way you're delivering them content that's more meaningful to them as individuals.
Okay. And then trends are huge, right? We see trends everywhere we go in anything from marketing to what people are searching for, what people are buying, what they're shopping for. What are some of the trends that stand out for you? And don't say TikTok. I mean, if that's the one you want to throw out there, okay, but what are some of the big marketing trends that you're seeing right now?
So all jokes aside, let's dig into TikTok a little bit. The reason we feel it works isn't because of the content itself, but it's real people, right? the days of putting out an advertisement with the stereotypical guy in blue overalls for a plumber and HVAC company, right? Or the days of, you know, here's this, you know, sad meme looking guy who just ends up in every advertisement because he's coming from stock imagery, they're kind of gone. People are buying real people anymore. So the way you can humanize yourself, put yourself, your team out there, however it may be, you know, they're more likely to invest in you and the experience than they are with just you as a service. Now, granted, you can bring promotions to the table that help that along, but you know, the trend is putting yourself out there. People buy real people anymore.
And we see that. We see that day in and day out, but we also see the hesitation. So another takeaway from this episode is really not being afraid to put yourself out there or put your team out there. Show the business. Mm-hmm. Show what you're doing for the holidays. Show how you're impacting the community around you. Forget the stock imagery. Forget, you know, the just words on a picture, but really showcase who you are, who your company is, who you are as individuals, and that's catching people's attention.
100%.
And if you want to have fun on TikTok, go for it, right? What's BJ doing on TikTok lately?
Absolutely nothing.
So one of the things that we always do on the episodes, and I know that you've been in the den before, but we want to try to give every guest the opportunity to give their final roar. Mm-hmm. We've talked a lot about different tips, tricks, and things like that that you see, but kind of what do you want to leave the audience with as they're thinking about their marketing for the holidays?
Absolutely. I'll say this. You know, by the time you're watching this, time is ticking, right? The holidays are coming and, you know, people are buying now. So don't waste any more time. Hit the ground running. Carve out the time to do something actionable and get it in front of your audience. You'll be able to watch that journey as it gets closer to the holidays and make decisions on, you know, how far you lean into something or how much you change it. But with that being said, take action today. Don't wait any further.
So we're going to keep this episode short because why the hell are you watching a podcast when you should be dealing with your marketing? So get out there, do what you need to do, take care of your clients, grow your business, and enjoy the holidays. BJ, thank you so much for joining us on this episode.
Thank you.
Everyone, I wish you the best. And if you have any questions, you can always leave comments below and we will take care of you.